Today's podcast is brought to you by Audible.com. Get a free audiobook download and a 30-day free trial at audibletrial.com/Dan's Book Reviews.
Dan the Art Man's Book Reviews, Episode 46, The Firm by Jon Grisham. This book was pretty good. I really enjoyed it, but it never thrilled me. I think that sums it up. I liked the characters, I liked the writing style, I just wish it hadn't been so easy for the good guys to win. Now, they had to do a lot of hard, stressful work to achieve their goals, and they could have been in very dire danger many times, but they just didn't quite have the all-is-lost moment. I felt like it was coming for a long time, and then the book was over. Okay, before I get to things that bothered me about the book, let me list the things I liked, because this was a fun book to read, and there's a lot to like. The slow build of this book was pretty great. You learn about the firm and why it's a creepy, bad place to be employed, in little pieces, bit by bit, throughout the book. This was well executed. Also, the characters came across as real people. They were fleshed out just enough. The firm as a setting was a character all its own. Much like a character should grow and change, the firm changes for you as a reader. Now, it doesn't actually change, but your perception of it does as you work your way through the story. You know from page one that it's not a great place to work, but you experience the lure of it through the eyes of the protagonist. And so it seems like a great and exciting place to work at first. A place of tremendous opportunity. Then as you fly through the chapters and its secrets are revealed, you discover what kind of place it really is. Although I do remember a few beautiful sentences here and there, describing movements of the weather and other things, Jon Grisham's writing style was refreshingly plain, but in a good way. It didn't get in the way of the story. The words just fly by as the story unfolds. This is no small task to write in this way. His writing has an easy way about it. I will definitely be reading more of his books in the future, because if he could write this well early in his career, I can't wait to see how well he can write with dozens of titles under his belt. One funny thing that surprised me while reading this book is that it inspired me to work harder on everything in life. You read about the main character putting in insane hours at the office, and you think, if he can do this, I can work extremely hard too. I always try and work hard at everything I do, but reading this novel seemed to give me a little boost in that department. It also made me thankful for my 9-to-5 job and that I'm not a lawyer. I like seeing my family. The main character was too confident. I think this may be a part of what made it seem like everything was always okay and that no danger would befall the characters. Now, Grisham sets up a fantastically scary atmosphere for the characters to live in. It would be terrifying, but the protagonist was so confident the whole way through that I just figured he would be fine since he wasn't really too worried about it. Maybe this was due to the fact that he kept having to convince his wife that everything would be all right. It kind of got to me the way that he spoke unabashedly to the FBI agents, like he was in charge. I guess it could be argued that this is what makes him such an awesome hero. What did you think of The Firm? Have you read it? Any other novels by Jon Grisham? I've been calling him Grishams because of this funny Key and Peele skit. Those guys are some comedians. Do you guys have any recommendations for Jon Grisham books? I'd love to hear them. Awesome. Yeah, I remember not being like totally blown away by this book, but also really enjoying it and finding a lot of amazing qualities in Jon Grisham's writing. Oh, I listened to the audiobook, and I have some great news for you guys, the listeners of this podcast. Audible, who sponsors this podcast, wants to give you a free audiobook. All you have to do is go to audibletrial.com/dansbookreviews. And you can get any audiobook of your choice, but this week I would recommend The Firm by Jon Grisham. It's narrated by one of my favorite narrators, Scott Brick, which made it such an amazing story to listen to because Scott Brick is just perfect for this. He has a very commanding voice, and that really fit well with the main character in The Firm. So go to audibletrial.com/dansbookreviews and get your free copy of The Firm by Jon Grisham, narrated by Scott Brick. Now, let's get back to that review. Yeah, I'm excited to read more Jon Grisham. I'm glad that I'm reading this review that I posted back in January 3rd of 2014. Today is August 5th of 2016. But yeah, I think I pretty much said everything I wanted to about this book in the review. Other than, like I said, I never felt like there was an all-is-lost moment. Even though the things that the characters had to do in the story would have been extremely stressful and they totally could have been caught and maybe even killed, because a lot of people end up dying in this book. Also, the character of The Firm, the thing the book's named after, was pretty amazing and creepy, and that was an awesome element in this book. So, I mean, I wouldn't give this 5 stars, but I do think it's worth reading, especially if, like me, you've never read a Jon Grisham book. And it's fun to take a side trip from reading only science fiction and fantasy stories. So check out The Firm, get it for free on Audible, and I'll see you guys next week. Until then, I hope that you've had a great summer of reading, and I'm going to get back to some reading myself. I'll see you guys next week. Take care. Mike, take it away.
This podcast is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution, non-commercial, no derivative works license. Music by Kevin MacLeod, found at incompetech.com. The website that goes with this podcast can be found at dandantheartman.com. And you can follow Dan on Twitter, Google+, and Facebook at dandantheartman. For Dan, this is Mike Luoma, saying happy reading, and we'll see you next time.